In this video, I'm going over my entire Air Jordan collection. We are at about 15 or so pairs, so stick around to the end of the video so that you can see the heat that I've picked up, as well as the stories that come along with each shoe. Let's get it going right after the drop. Now, before we get started with the first shoe, let me know in the comments how many Jordans you have in your collection, or if you don't have any, let me know the one that you are most dying to pick up. So let's get into number one with the Air Jordan 1, right? This is the 2016 version. I picked these up in that same year, and I actually paid resale for these, which is the first time I had ever done that on a pair of shoes. I paid around $600 for these, which is a lot of money, but you know what? This is my favorite shoe of all time, so it was well worth it. The quality on these is amazing, and I really struck out online, so that was sort of my only option, was paying resale. Either way, I put a ton of miles on these, so they're worth every penny. For the number two shoe, we are looking at the Air Jordan 3 in the black cement colorway. This is the 2008 version that came in the countdown pack. This is such an amazing shoe. It is one of the best shoes of all time and almost single-handedly saved Jordan brand. It is the first Jordan shoe to feature the actual Jumpman logo, and it is the first shoe also in the Jordan line to feature the visible air unit. This is of course made famous from when Jordan jumped from the free throw line, and it is a very special shoe for me because I actually bought this off of my good friend Kadeem, who has since passed away. So shout out to Kadeem for this one. And you know what? He's such an amazing dude. He's one of those style icons that inspired me to make this channel. So this is definitely one of my favorite shoes in my collection, and just so happens to also be one of the greatest shoes of all time. Next up is another personal favorite. You're gonna hear me say that a lot in this video, and this is the Air Jordan 4 in the bread colorway 2019 version. Picked these up last year, which is weird to say now that it's 2020, but definitely one of the best releases of the year. I actually did a poll on my Instagram to see the most popular and everybody's favorite sneaker of the year, and this was such a close runner-up to the Travis Scott Air Jordan 1, which is definitely a great pickup, but it's great to see that you guys are loving these. Nike Air the back, super fresh colorway, goes with a ton of different stuff, and the quality on these is actually really good. So I'm really happy that I have these in my collection. Moving on with the bread colored sneakers, you are looking at the Bread 11. I also picked these up this year, of course. My only gripe with the shoe is that this, the carbon fiber plate on the bottom sort of looks like fake version of a Jordan 11, but nonetheless, this is of course real, and this is just one of the best sneakers of all time, up there with the Jordan 3s for one of the GOATs. What can I say about this? All black with the red bottom. I think I do like the Concords a little bit better, but the one thing that this has over the Concords, in my opinion, is that these are a little bit more wearable, and it is a true Bulls colorway. The Air Jordan 11, super comfortable shoe as well, a little bit clunky, but the cushioning setup in it is really amazing. This is the first shoe to feature a patent leather upper, and it also brought Jordan out of retirement, so shout out to Tinker Hatfield for designing the sneaker. And would you know, another pair of Jordan 11s, of course, as I just mentioned, this is the Concord version. Super loud shoe, absolutely love it. There's something about the white with the black patent leather. There's a ton of contrast in the sneaker between the upper and the actual leather piece, but it just somehow flows together with the translucent midsole and that actual flash of Concord. For those of you that don't know, the reason why these are actually called the Concords is because of this little flash of purple right here that you see on the bottom. I don't know why it's called the Concord when it's such a small little piece right there. There's also a Concord purple Jumpman on the tongue over here, but nonetheless, this is one of the best sneakers of all time, and a cool story behind it with the Tinker Hatfield design elements to it. Next is the Air Jordan 6 in the infrared colorway. This is the 2016 version of it, so that you guys should notice that the infrared hits is actually more of a pink color as opposed to a red. I picked these up 2 years ago at a local sneaker trade show in my neighborhood, and these are just an amazing shoe. They were slightly worn, so I got them for an amazing price. Great that these re-released in 2019 as well. But I missed on that pickup just because I did have this pair, and it was still in great they're still in great condition right now. What I love most about these is that they also have these little dots right here. These are actually 3M perforation on this shoe. So if you put a flash to it, it will light up. My only gripe, I absolutely love this particular pair of Air Jordan 6s. My only gripe with it is that the Air Jordan 6 is kind of uncomfortable, so I actually threw in a different, don't tell anyone, but I threw in a Yeezy 350 V2 insole on these just to add in some extra comfort. But either way, I love the shoe, and well, let me know what you guys think about this, the tag placement right here. I switched it from here to there. But either way, gotta love the Air Jordan 6. Next, White Cement 4, one of my favorite sneakers of all time as well. This is actually the first Jordan Retro that I actually purchased, and it is one of my favorites of all time. These came out in 2012, so it's been a crazy 8 years with this shoe. These things are like tanks in sort of a bad way. The quality on these is really terrible, but I actually just posted a video of an update of wearing the shoe for 8 years, so I'm gonna leave it in the card up above. So if you are interested in learning more about this sneaker and me going in depth with it, you can definitely check that out. Yellowing a bit on the sides, on the mesh sides over there. But like I said, these are an amazing shoe, and I absolutely love them. Cement print is super unique on these, so I'm really glad to have these in my collection. Next up is one of the newer colorways that we are seeing. This is the Air Jordan 8 in the OVO colorway. Great shoe. The only issue with the Air Jordan 8 is that it is very clunky. It's a very dense sneaker, not very flexible. So I do typically wear these only in the winter time. I live in Toronto, Canada. Snows a shit ton, so these are sort of my winter Jordan sneakers. So I put a lot of miles into these, and I'm really happy with them. The quality on these is amazing, and you know what, to be honest, you know, Drake may not be the center of fashion, and he actually said in his recent interview that he doesn't really care to be known for his sneakers, but I'm always happy to see, you know, Air Jordans and an OVO collab. I love the details on these. They have the owl on the hang tag and the welcome behind the tongue right here, and once again, the quality is really great on these. I do really enjoy all black sneakers, specifically with Jordan, so I'm also looking forward to those black Cat 4s that are coming out. Next up is the Raptor Air Jordan 7. The Air Jordan 7 is one of the more slept on models in my opinion, and I'm really hoping that Jordan Brand puts out more colorways of these, particularly with the Bordeaux. I know we saw them release a couple years back, but there's still a ton of colorways that are great, like the Orion colorway, as well as the Cardinal 7s. Those are some OG colorways, so hopefully those release. And I just think that it's amazing. I mentioned that I'm from Toronto, that the city, we actually got our own colorway of a pair of Jordans, and you know what, I hold these near and dear to my heart, especially since they won the championship last year. So this is an amazing shoe, and one that I'll keep in my collection forever. Next up is the Air Jordan 5 in the black metallic colorway. This is one of the first shoes that you know, I purchased when I started working full-time, so this is sort of a sign of, you know, regular full-time paycheck, so I'm really glad that I got these. These came out in, I believe, 2016, rather, and this is just the best colorway, in my opinion, of the Air Jordan 5. I absolutely love the design of the shoe, especially with the Nike Air on the back, but I personally just don't find that these look the best on me on feet. Either way, you know, if you rock these with a pair of all-black denim, slim-fitting, or even, you know, a pair of shorts with some high cut socks, some gray socks, it's also a good look in my opinion as well. So definitely a versatile shoe, cool design elements with this sort of military design. This is sort of designed after a fighter jet, if I'm not mistaken, and like I said, my favorite colorway of the Air Jordan 5s, and I'm really glad to have these in my collection. Another pair of shoes that I picked up around the same time as the black metallics is this pair of True Blue Air Jordan 3s. One of my favorite Air Jordan 3 colorways, as you can imagine. And this was around the time when they started throwing Nike Air on the back, so I always appreciate that. And quality on these is actually pretty good. They're sort of tanks, and I've destroyed these in a sense, but either way, this is still a crispy looking pair, even though I put a ton of miles on these. And this is just an amazing shoe. You know, you wear these with a white, plain white t-shirt and a pair of blue denim, and who's better than you? I don't know, you tell me. So I absolutely love this colorway, even though it's sort of like a more of a Wizards colorway than it is a Bulls colorway. Either way, this is still technically an OG Air Jordan. So these came out in they obviously didn't come out in 88, but they did come out when they were still originally putting the Nike Air on the back, so I'm glad these got the same treatment. Now, next up is the oldest sneaker in my collection. This came out in 2006. Wow, that was a long time ago, 12 years ago. So it's just amazing that these shoes are kind of still holding up, because these are absolutely just destroyed. I bought these at SneakerCon Toronto in 2018, and look at the heels on these. They have completely fallen off. Let me show you guys what they're supposed to look like. This is the other pair of Air Jordan 3s. So as you can see, this entire tab has fallen off, and you can just see there that it's cracking. Nonetheless, despite the plastic falling off, the quality on these is amazing. The comfort on these is just amazing for the fact that they came out in 2006. I just absolutely love this colorway right here. And if these released, I would 100% buy another pair. I love gray Jordans. And yeah, these is just an amazing shoe. And you know, it's definitely one that I'm a little bit scared to wear just because they are falling apart on me. But either way, absolutely love these and I'm glad that I have them. Guys, just a couple more pairs left, but let's look at the Air Jordan 1 Low. This is the Shattered Backboard colorway, one of the most slept on sneakers that released in 2019. And the reason for that is just because it is an iconic colorway with the Shattered Backboard highs being so expensive. But the fact that there's just a little bit less material, it just goes to show how hype can really drive the value of a shoe. This is such an amazing shoe. It is extremely comfortable and it just, I don't know what it is. Maybe it just fits the proportions of my feet, but when I put it on, let me tell you something, it just feels right and I can't wait to wear these more in the summertime. So this is just an amazing shoe and I'm very happy to have them, as I keep saying. But nonetheless, quality on these is great too. So, you know, I'm really glad that the Air Jordan 1 Lows are starting to gain popularity, because when I was first coming up into sneakers, this was not a thing. Air Jordan 1s in general were not a huge sought after sneaker. It wasn't until recently that they became really, really popular. And yeah, believe it or not, the first colorway, one of the first Air Jordans I ever owned was a pair of Air Jordan 1 Lows in the Northside colorway. So I can pull that up on screen. Those got completely trashed. I no longer have them because I ended up like skateboarding in them. If you think about it, this is actually a decent skateboarding shoe, but fun shoe right here. Next up, as you can see, this is the Air Jordan 1 KO in the, I think it's photo blue, I can't remember. But either way, this is an interesting shoe. I actually purchased these at, not StockX, at Flight Club in New York for a decent price. These are an all canvas sneaker, and that's the difference between them and a regular pair of Air Jordan 1s, as well as a regular highs will have the back heel over there as well. So here's a comparison to the Air Jordan 1. As you can see, the heel is a little bit different and the size of the swoosh material as well. This is a plastic material right here. And yeah, this is just, it's an interesting shoe. I don't really wear it that much, but I'm glad to have them. And I love, this is sort of the poor man's Royal. So as you can see, I was on that wave when they first came out. So interesting shoe and still tells a story given the fact that this was the first shoe that I picked up in New York at Flight Club. So something interesting. All right, and last but not least, this is a very underrated Jordan right here. This is the Air Jordan 3 in the wool colorway. This is just an absolute beast in the winter time. This wool upper is waterproof, and I just love the cream midsole that they have on here. I know it might look white on screen, but this is more of an off-white color. And this is a great lifestyle Jordan. It's still a Jordan retro. And as you can tell, I love the Air Jordan 3. I love the mid-cut of it. And this is definitely a very comfortable Jordan. I wore these just the other day. And yeah, it's great. It's a cool monochrome, you know, Jordan, so you can sort of wear it in different occasions. It's not as flashy and kind of goes under the radar, but I actually picked these up from eBay for around $100, so super cheap. And yeah, it's an interesting shoe, tells a story, and it's something that you don't see every day, which is something that I appreciate. You know, a lot of these retros that you see came out this year, you know, you walk around the mall, everybody's gonna be wearing the same pairs of shoes, but this one is a little bit different. So I have a ton of how to style videos where I show how to put these Jordans in a bunch of outfits. So I want you guys to click that video right over there and I'll meet you guys there. So if you guys are interested in learning about how to style Jordans and, you know, tips and tricks on how to rock them in different outfits, I'll meet you guys there.